With her husband, Ed, suffering severe chest pains, Kathy Hoffman is convinced that he is having a heart attack. They rush to the hospital.
I went in and I said, my husband's having chest pains. And man, he was in the emergency room and stuff stuck on him and before I could hardly blink. The doctor ordered blood work. She ordered scans.
The doctor makes a surprising discovery.
She said, your spleen is hugely enlarged.
The spleen is an abdominal organ that filters and purifies blood.
This enlarged spleen was pushing on his diaphragm, causing chest pains. It wasn't the heart at all.
Doctors suspect that Ed has a bacterial infection, so they prescribe a course of antibiotics.
What a relief at that point.
For the next few weeks, Ed tries to recuperate, but he doesn't completely improve.
We had told the grandkids that they could go to Washington, D.C. over spring break, and they were so excited. But Ed kept telling me he just could not do it. And I wanted to cancel the trip, and he would not let me because he was not going to disappoint the grandkids.
Kathy leaves Ed at home with family and friends and proceeds with the trip.
We were outside a souvenir store. And all of a sudden, one of these friends called and said, he is really much worse. I was kicking myself for going and not canceling this trip. I would tell the kids, we gotta pray for Grandpa. Grandpa's gotten really much worse.
Kathy cuts the trip short and flies home immediately, while Ed is rushed to the hospital. There, pathologist Dr. Robert Palmer takes over his case.
He looked like death warmed over.
Doctors run numerous tests.
But we really couldn't figure out what was going on. It was a total mystery.
At the hospital, Kathy arrives to a shocking sight.
When I saw him, he was confused, out of it. He was a sick man.
He was actually deteriorating real fast. He was losing a lot of weight. He was running fever. He was gonna die with his disease or whatever it was before we had a definitive diagnosis to treat it.
That's scary.
So Dr. Palmer makes a drastic decision.
I said, he's dying. We have got to do something now. Let's take him up to surgery and take the spleen out, and maybe we can figure out what the problem is. You can live without a spleen.
I didn't say goodbye. I said, I love you. It's gonna be okay.
In theater, surgeons labor for hours to extract the spleen. Kathy sits anxiously in the waiting room.
Some of the family was there. The surgery seemed like it took a long time, but the doctor came out and told us that that spleen was 3 to 4 times as big as it should have been. But he got it out.
The surgical team brings the organ to Dr. Palmer's pathology lab.
When I looked at the slides under the microscope, I saw some little blue dots. What is going on here? What are those little blue dots? I started taking out a pathology book. And that's when I found Ed had visceral leishmaniasis.
Leishmaniasis? Just the name of it sounded scary.
Visceral leishmaniasis is caused by the parasite Leishmania donovani. The Leishmania parasite invades the white blood cells. There, they multiply, causing these immune cells to burst. As Ed's spleen struggles to filter out the growing parasitic colonies, the organ swells. Meanwhile, the parasites spread rapidly, depriving Ed's body of vital nutrients, contributing to his lethargy, cravings for high-fat foods, and dramatic weight loss.
To find out that there's a parasite living in your body is terrifying.
Leishmania parasites are responsible for up to 30,000 deaths worldwide every year. One of the reasons the parasites are so deadly is because they have a special coating that prevents the host's immune cells from attacking them.
By directly compromising his immune system, the parasites can course through his body unrestrained. To save Ed's life, Dr. Palmer must use chemotherapy to attack the parasites across his body.
He had a bug that was acting like a cancer. The chemotherapy will attack the leishmaniasis organisms anywhere they are.
Day after day, Ed endures the treatment.
It's awful to sit there and watch that drip all day. It was a terrible worry. How do you know that they got this?
Family and friends gather at the hospital. After 5 days, Ed's condition suddenly improves.
They were wheeling me down the hallway, and I seen a hallway filled with people. My family, my friends. There must have been 20, 25 people there. I think all them people were there because they cared about me.
Leishmania parasites typically cycle between female sandflies and mammals, such as humans or dogs. When an infected sandfly takes a blood meal from a mammal, the parasites enter the mammal's bloodstream. There, the infection often takes several months to develop. Leishmania parasites are endemic in tropical and subtropical regions across the world, including Central and South America, and even Southern Europe.
For this reason, doctors believe Ed didn't contract his illness in Puerto Rico, but on a trip 6 months prior.
We were traveling throughout southern Spain in the rural areas, and that's where I must have been bitten by the sandfly.
To get so sick from such a little thing and have it do so much damage is pretty amazing.
The next day, doctors discharge Ed from the hospital. Today, 3 years later, he has fully recovered.
Life for a spleen, I'll take it any day. My survival through this thing is the love of my family and just my belief in God and damn good doctors.